Hi guys, hope you are doing well. I want to welcome you all in this video series that is Aircraft Explain ATA Wise, and in this video I am going to explain ATA 11, that is placarding and marking of the aircraft. So first of all, we should have to understand what is this placarding and marking means. So I will start this discussion with a very simple example, that is chips. You have bought any chips from the market or any medicine or any other product, you will find there are lot of information written on the packet, like name of the medicine, expiry date, manufacturing date, serial number, what are the things that you should not do with the medicine or a chips or anything. Okay, so there are lot of information written. Same and likewise in aviation industry also, in aircraft component also, or on the whole aircraft also, we will use this placarding and marking. That means we will use to do it so that we will easily identify any component, we can easily understand anything, or we can give any warning or caution that should be followed when any person is working on it or boarding, like travelers, all the passengers are going inside the aircraft. So what are the things that they should have to take care of, like what are the warnings, what are the cautions. Okay, so basically, placarding and marking are used in the aviation industry so that we can easily identify, we will not misunderstood anything, and we will have to take care of ourselves also, because the systems of the aircraft are very powerful that can even cause death or injury of any person. Okay, so what to warn or to make sure that they should not do all these things, we will use this placarding and marking. Okay, so what is the difference between placarding and marking? See, marking means when with the help of sign or with the help of symbol, with the help of lines, you are communicating anything to the traveler, to the passenger, or to the personal who is working, like engineers, pilots, then it is called marking, as you can see in the figure. But when any information is written in words or sentences or in lines, like in the seat you will find like fasten your seat belt, you, on the seat only you will find like life jackets are inside, or inside the seat only. So all these information is type of placarding when they are externally pasted on some system or on the aircraft body. It can be of many types. It can be of permanent type, it can be temporary type, it can be like you can just layer off and you can paste it on the aircraft structure. It can be that cannot get pasted by itself, so you have to paste some glue that is called adhesive on it so that it can paste on the aircraft. But why it is necessary? I have already told you, because the systems of aircraft are very complicated, they are very complex, they can be dangerous for anyone. So to avoid that dangerousness or to avoid that casualties and all, we will use this placarding and marking. As you can see in the figure also, if you have seen the engine of the aircraft, there are a lot of markings on it, there are a lot of placards on the engine, so that you can avoid the damages. Like the engine is using fuel burning, that are burning inside the engine, so the engine can be hot, very hot, after even the shutdown of the engine. So it will be placarded there, it will be written like hot, HOT, in the red color, so that by distance only you will get to know, okay, we'll have to take care while going near to the engine. Okay, same precautions are written in near the air conditioning system. Like air conditioning system are running continuously, they can cause danger. So this is one perspective. The second perspective is, if any person is working on any system on the aircraft, like maintenance personnel, okay, that system obviously can be operated by the cockpit. So if they are working on just for example, they are working on APU, that is auxiliary power unit of the aircraft, so they will placard, they will just put one placard, small placard on the cockpit that maintenance is in progress, or they will provide any placard on the switch that do not operate this switch. Okay, why? Because if some person by mistake came inside the cockpit and just switch on that APU, that is auxiliary power unit, the person who is working on the APU will be in the dangerous, that can cause casualty also. Okay, because the systems of the aircraft are very powerful. Okay, so to avoid all these things, we will use the placarding and marking, and they are on every part of the aircraft. Even you can see the name of the manufacturer, like it is Boeing or Airbus, you will find like the registration of the aircraft, you will find the flag of the country in which the aircraft is registered, you will find lot of information on the aircraft with the help of this placarding and marking, so that it is for all, like the maintenance personnel, like the operational persons, like all the travelers that are traveling inside and outside the aircraft, so that the injury, the warnings and the cautions can be easily communicated. Okay, so this is a very basic idea about this ATA 11, that is placarding and marking. If you find the video is helpful, hit the like, subscribe it, share with all your friends so that everyone can get the benefit.